Welcome to this brief guide on how to use branching in Microsoft Forms. When using Microsoft Forms, you may find yourself in an instance where you would like to split your form based on a user's results. This is called branching, and I'll show you how to do this today. The first thing we'll need to do is open up Microsoft Edge and head to the Office homepage. Once here, we'll use the app launcher found in the top left-hand corner and select the option for Microsoft Forms. This will bring us to the Forms homepage. When here, we could select to create a new form, but for this demonstration, I've already created a form called Coffee with Paul, and I'm going to utilize that here. On this form, I've got a few different questions that will show up. One, which is asking users to select a day that they would like to join me for coffee. But I'd like the results that show up afterwards for this question to differ depending on the day that a user selects. So on Monday, Tuesday, and Friday, I'd like to give them the early options. And then for Wednesday and Thursday, I prefer my coffee a little bit later in the day. So how do I do that? I use branching. In order to show branching, simply select your question and use the ellipsis menu found in the lower right-hand corner. And you'll have options to shuffle options, use drop-downs, subtitles, or the bottom option that we want, add branching. That will give you options to dictate where each response will take the user. By default, everything is set to take the user straight to the next question. But in this case, when I select Wednesday, I get options to choose a different question. So I'm going to have Wednesday and Thursday take the user to question 3 instead of question 2. Now, as a result of changing these options as well, what we'll need to do is actually go down to question 2 in just a moment. And we'll need to change some branching as well so that users automatically finish the form when they make their choice in question 2 instead of going on to question 3. Now, it's not necessarily needed in this instance, but I'm also just going to have question 3 also end the form for each user. But please note, if you wanted to, you could have question 3 go back to question 1 if you really wanted to as well. Once all of my options are selected, I simply click back. And you'll notice now next to my title, I have a little branching icon to let me know that branching is in effect for this particular form. And this is what it will look like for the user. They will have the option to choose what day they would like to join me for coffee. In this case, I'll select Tuesday, and we'll get the options for the earlier time slots in the day, at which point the user can select a time, in this case, 8:30. And they hit submit, and instead of seeing question 3, that is just their response completely submitted. Now, if I select Wednesday, instead the user sees the later times that I have selected. They still believe it is question 2, whereas I know it's question 3 on my form, but they can then make their choices and hit submit, and their form will be submitted as well. If I need to make any changes, I can simply select the back option and head back to my survey and make any changes needed there. And that is branching in Microsoft Forms. I hope you found this tip useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.